So now you will learn some standard queuing models. Earlier we completed the different terminologies associated with solving numericals, lambda, mu, waiting line, queue line, and many other things in the previous videos in the introduction part. So we already covered the introduction part of the queuing theory. Now before entering directly to the numerical, let us know what are the models we are going to solve in the numericals. Here I have written all the models which are included in this particular queuing theory. But in our MacOut syllabus of operation research, they have only three models that I will discuss in the meantime. So let us start with the first model. The first model says it will be a system of single server with poison arrivals and with exponential service. So you know the arrival lambda and the service rate, you know, is given by mu. And now it says it in the first model there will be a single server with poison arrival and with exponential service. Now there is one more thing given over here. The population model will be infinite, okay? And this particular model is, this you can say as code, okay, m/m/1, and this one depicts FCFS, means first come first service, first come first served, okay? So you can say this model is single server poison arrival with exponential service. Now in this particular model there are some assumptions I can read out for you. Look, I am following the Mahajan book, and there are many more books available in the market. Good books are there also, like you can consult Panit Silvam and J.P. Gupta, and there are Taha, okay, Rao. So there are many other books you can consult also for practicing different topics of operation research. Now for this particular model one, I can say in this the assumptions of this particular model are the both the arrivals and service rates are independent of the number of customers in the waiting line. This is the first one. The second one is the arrivals occur at random according to Poisson's distribution, okay? And there will be only one queue and one service, single server. So there will be one queue and one service facility, okay? And the arrivals will be handled by FCFS, you already know. And you can also say that the last assumption is mean service rate. I already discussed what is mean service rate earlier. Mean service rate, that is, you can also write it as mu. Mean service rate is higher than the mean arrival rate. Okay, this is the arrival rate, lambda. You already know what are lambda and mu. So mean service rate is higher than the mean arrival rate. Now coming to the model 2, it says multi-channel. It says multi-channel queuing theory, and it is also given as FCFS, that means first come first serve. Now in this particular model 2, we are having this is basically applicable to where there are several servers, you know, multi-servers, multi-channel. From the name you can already assume that there can be several servers in the service facility to provide the particular service. Now these servers are arranged in parallel, and each unit in the waiting line can be served by any one of them, okay? So the servers will be arranged in in the parallel manner. I have already shown in the previous videos what is parallel server and what is the series server. These are the series servers, and these are the parallel servers. So, and the assumptions for this particular model, I can read out for you. You can also check in the book. The assumptions are already written over the book, but still I can read out for you. In this particular model, the assumptions are several servers in the service facility. As you already know, this is a multi-channel queuing system. So several servers in the service facility, the servers are arranged in parallel. Okay, this one is a parallel service. Customers wait in a single queue, okay, until any one of the server become free to render the service. Next one is the service discipline is FCFS, that is first come first serve. Next is the arrival rate and service rate are mean values from Poisson distribution and exponential distribution. Okay. Next is the service rate is same for each server. A very important thing, service rate. You already know what is service rate. there is the average number of customers, you know, served for unit time. So the service rate is same for each server for this particular module 2. And the average arrival rate, okay, average arrival rate is less than the combined average service rate of all servers. That means, if I can say, and that is a lambda is the arrival rate, you can say, is less than C dot U, you can say, over here. Now, what is C? You know, C is the number of servers, okay, C is the number of servers, and, you know, so it says the average arrival rate should be less than the combined average service of all servers. You can also give it as mu also. Okay. So coming to the next, one more assumption is there for model 2 also. That is the queue is of infinite length. Queue is of infinite length. Okay. Now coming to the model 3. Model 3 says it will be a Poisson input exponential service, single server, first come first serve. This will be finite queue length, infinite population. This model also has finite queue length as of the previous model. Okay, so the model 2 and model 3 has a you can say finite queue length. Okay, now coming to the application of model 3, you can say when the queue can accommodate only a limited or you can say finite number of arrivals. This particular model is designed for finite number of arrivals. Arrival, this one is the arrival lambda. Okay, so finite number of arrivals is for model 3. New arrivals join the queue if the space is available. So unless and until new space is available, the new arrivals will join the queue. And if the queue is full, the arrival leaves the system without joining the queue for this particular model 3. Okay. So this particular model can have some real life examples also. You can see queue formation at parking place, or you can say at a doctor's clinic, or you can say at restaurants or in barber shops. Okay. Now let us see the model 4. In model 4, it says Poisson input, which is of kth order, Erlangian distribution, single server, FCFS, first come first served, no restriction on queue length. That is the new term. Initially it was of finite length, but this one is of infinite, no restriction on queue length. Okay, and the last one is the infinite customer population. Okay, that model also, this one, model 1 also having infinite population model. Okay, so these are the basic models, standard models, you can say, in particular queuing models course. But in your syllabus they are saying that we have only to read this model 1, then you have to read this model 2, and they are saying Poisson input with arbitrary service rate, you can say. So this one also. Okay, and now, and there is also another model which we'll read, that is the queue models with Poisson input and constant service rate. Okay, and after reading these models and solving problems based on this particular models, the last part of the particular this module, that is the queuing theory, we are going to have another heading, that is the economic analysis of waiting lines. That will be the last one for this particular topic. So, you know, this is all about the standard queuing models. In the next part, I'm going to solve each and every model. I'm going to select a particular problem, one or two, so that you can get a clear idea or how to solve certain numericals in your upcoming semester examinations, as well as in your GATE exams or in any competitive exams. Thank you.